good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's look at a simple molecule and predict which fragments will be observed. Here is a molecule. If someone asks what fragments are likely from this molecule, then almost any fragmentation might seem reasonable. Any bond in this molecule could break and generate fragments. The question, however, is not which fragments are possible, but which fragments are likely. So let's start with the parent ion. In a mass spectrometer, we would likely lose an electron in the lone pair to give this parent ion. It has an MZ value of 1.15. Fragmentation occurs at or near the radical cation center. So we will likely see breaking of bonds either directly attached to the nitrogen or adjacent to the nitrogen. Here again is the parent ion. Let's specifically label the bonds that might break. We mentioned bonds to the nitrogen. That could be the CN bond, bond A. How about the NH bonds? Those are possible, but NH bonds are pretty strong and normally stay put. We also mentioned bonds adjacent to the radical cation. That would mean the bonds on this carbon. Make that darker. So, this CC bond, bond B, this CC bond, bond C, and this CH bond, bond D. These bonds should break to form our main fragments. I'm just going to show fragments in this table, not the mechanisms. The mechanisms would be either radical or cation site initiated pathways. There is a link in the upper right to the mechanism video. Okay, so bond A, one way of breaking bond A will give this cation with an MZ of 16 and this unobserved neutral radical, which has a mass of 99. The other way of breaking bond A would give this neutral fragment with a mass of 99 that's neutral and unobserved. And this cation, which has an MZ of 99. So for bond B, we could break this to give a radical, a neutral radical unobserved, that has a mass of 29, as well as this cation, which has an MZ of 86, and of course we're going to observe the cation. We could also fragment off of bond B to give this net neutral fragment. Our cation is MZ of 29 and the neutral fragment is 86, unobserved. For bond C, we could get this cation fragment with an MZ of 58, as well as this radical fragment, which is neutral, has a mass of 57. And the other way to break bond C would give us this net neutral fragment, which has a mass of 58, but we won't observe it, and this cation fragment, which has an MZ of 57. Finally, we could break bond D, and we have to draw that in. That's our hydrogen. One way to break this would give a cation with a mass, an MZ value, of 114. We would lose a hydrogen radical that has a mass of 1. It's unobserved. The other way to cleave this would be to give H plus, and that would be our cation fragment with an MZ of 1, and that's what we would observe. So, with just 4 bonds to consider, we still have many likely fragments, 8 in total, although not all of these will likely be observed. Note that from the original molecule, you might expect that a methyl group would be possible. This molecule does have 2 methyl groups, but based on the position of the radical cation, we actually wouldn't predict loss of a methyl group. Ethyl fragments, this molecule again has 2. Although there are 2 in this particular, it's this particular ethyl group that might break off, but the ethyl on the right is not a likely fragment. So from a starting molecule, focus on the likely parent ion and the position of the radical cation will help you determine which fragments are most likely. I hope this longish video helps you predict likely MS fragments from a molecule. Please like, subscribe, or leave a question or comment. Take care.